حاضر، وهي سوها التيار. Soha is a PhD student at the University of Edinburgh, and she is her research interests include language attitudes in social linguistics, teaching Arabic for speakers of other languages, and needs analysis, and then also language course design.
Yeah, thank you, Giorgia. Thank you for this introduction. I'm really glad to have a chance talking with you today. Can I start? Thank you so much. Yeah, indeed, I already have recorded my presentation, and I will just open it for the audience now. Please tell me if the sound is...
An exploration of the effective things of our in a language institute and a Saudi
Arabian. And no, it's not very clear.
Oh, sorry. What about now?
This is just the outline as we see here.
Until now?
So what we mean by Arabic for academic purpose, AAP?
No, it's quite low. No.
Arabic specific purposes program. Its aim to help.
What about now?
To study, conduct research.
Can you add your volume of the computer if you are using your laptop, please? If you increase, make maximum volume, then.
So you should share the sound. So at the moment you're only sharing the video, you should share the sound as well.
Okay. How can I share the sound?
Same problem we had in the previous one.
Yeah. How can I deal with that?
So we said there's a button at the top at the bottom. Sorry, there's a button at the bottom.
Which one?
The green one.
Yeah.
In where?
So in the Zoom.
Yeah. Yeah, share new, the green, your screen sharing, yeah?
So, yeah, so when you start sharing, there's a button that says share the sound.
Okay, shall I close now the sharing, so, and repeat?
Yeah. And then you will
have the
sound.
Yeah. My sharing. Okay. Sharing screen. Then green button, share computer sound. Yeah, sorry for that. An exploration of the effectiveness of Arabic for academic purposes program in a language teaching institute at a Saudi Arabian university. And this is the study outline as you see here. So what we mean by Arabic for academic purposes AAP. AAP, it's similar to English for academic purpose. It's a branch of Arabic specific purposes program. Its aim to helping learners to study, conduct research, or teaching in that language. Arabic for academic purpose divide into two categories: Arabic for general academic purpose and Arabic for specific academic purpose. The Arabic for general academic purpose deal with language forms and skills that could be common to all discipline. For example, listening to lectures, taking notes, reading textbook, and so on. Whereas Arabic for specific academic purpose deal with the language forms skills that are related to a particular disciplines. For example, terminology and language patterns used in a specific field. So what we mean by program evaluation? Program evaluation process is a process for collecting information about different aspects of a language program in order to understand how the program works and how successfully it works. It aims to determine the program effectiveness in meeting student needs and looks at the suitability of the program's components, such as goals, objectives, teachers, teaching time, also teaching method used, and so on. In a language program evaluation process, there is a flexibility for a researcher to decide the appropriate time for conducting evaluation studies. For example, they can do it at the beginning of the program, or during the program, or at the end of the program. So I decided to conduct this research because indeed in Saudi Arabia there is a growing number of non-native Arabic speaker students, or we call them sometimes overseas students, who wish to study at Saudi University. However, before they can do so, they must complete 2 years of learning Arabic for academic purpose within one of the university's Arabic language institutes to prepare them linguistically and academically in achieving their goal. However, some studies was mentioned that those students are suffering from several academic difficulties, such as inability to communicate with their Arab partners, difficulty in understanding the content of the university lectures, and difficulty in reading academic textbooks, and so on. Some researchers indeed have related this to the lack of Arabic applied studies in the area of AAP course evaluating and developing, which can provide a basic theoretical background for teacher to design Arabic specialized language program that can meet the diverse need of overseas students, not just in the Saudi academic context, but also in other wider academic teaching Arabic language communities around the world. So, this research attempt to exploring the effectiveness of Arabic for academic purpose program in meeting the academic need of overseas students at one female university in Riyadh, in Saudi Arabia. At the end, depend on the study's result, a theoretical principle for developing of Arabic for academic purpose practice in this particular context will be suggested. The research funding could significantly contribute to the field of AAP by offering or providing insight into the problematic factor that impact on AAP program effectiveness in order to help stakeholders, whether teacher, administrator, course designer, decision makers, to find appropriate solution for this problem. Also, it could provide information about whether teaching material, method used by the program teacher are effective. Also, it show the program strength to help teacher keep with it, and also highlight it is weaknesses in order to help them resolve these and avoid them in future. It may also give or provide information about teacher professional level and competency in teaching AAP class. It also help rise stakeholders' awareness of the significant role of the course evaluation process in improving AAP course content, components, and outcome. Finally, it will it also play a useful social role in building learners' self-confidence by engaging them in the evaluating process and show them that their voice, need, and interest are significant. In related literature review, there is three main approaches to conduct AAP program evaluation studies. The first is formative evaluation, which is conducted to identify which of the program components are or are not progressing well, and it mainly aims to improve and develop the program design, whereas a summative evaluation, which is the second type of the approach for conducting evaluation studies, is dealing or focusing on determining the effectiveness of the program, it is efficiency, and to some extent dealing with it is acceptability. And it's also take place after a program has been implemented. Whereas the last type of approach for conducting AAP program evaluation studies is the illuminative evaluation, which is seeking to find out the different or how different aspect of the program work or being implemented, and it is also seek to provide a deeper understanding of the process of teaching and learning that occur in the program without necessarily seeking to change the course in any way. The methodology indeed used in this study is the case study methodology, which is choosing in order to gain sufficient information about the effectiveness of AAP program in satisfying the academic needs of overseas students in this particular institute. Our university institute. Indeed, I chose this methodology because it gave me a chance to take this information from or study this issue in its natural setting and from the perspective of all stakeholders who are involved in this context. The data collecting method I used is a triangulation method, which is include semi-structured interviews with 20 overseas students and two members of AAP administrating staff, also focusing group interviews with four members of AAP teaching method staff. The third method used also direct observation in some AAP classroom, and the last method used for data collection is collecting official AAP document. This study is a summative evaluation which is carried out using framework developing by myself as a researcher, which is motivated by the vision of course evaluation models proposed by Hutchinson and Waters. Therefore, in this study, I divide the data collection method in two parts. In the first part, I focus on identify which of the student academic needs are or are not met by the certain program. In the second part, I focus on explore the main problematic factor that affect the program effectiveness in meeting the student. As we can see here, the data collected from the interviews with student, teacher, and administrator show that writing skills, writing academic skills, was the only skills that developed in this program. So that means the student have only learned how to develop their writing academic skills. For example, they have learned how to develop an outline of the research, academic research, and writing reports, paraphrasing, summarizing paragraphs. Here there is some samples of student opinion when I ask them what they have learned through this program. As we can see here, Zahra have said, "We started to learn how to do research and the principles to organize research. It was very useful to me," Zahra said. Whereas Noha, the AAP teacher, was said, "They memorized how to do the summary very well." Gadir, the AAP administrator, was said, when I asked her the same question, she said, "It is possibly in scientific research skill, skills, or the principle of research skills in the syllables called study skills in the level 4. Only this is what I can tell you about it. She means there is no more skills that student was learned during this program. In this slide, as we can see, the result or the data collected from the classroom observation and official AAP related document show that the skill that not developed in this program was listening skills. For example, understanding the lecture content, listening to the and taking notes, and understanding relation between parts of the lectures. Reading skills also wasn't developed, such as skimming and reading to understand the academic text and exam questions. Also, speaking skills wasn't developed, such as delivering oral presentation, asking and answering questions, and interacting in the lecture. Academic vocabulary also wasn't learned during the course by the student, such as understanding the common and subject-specific academic vocabulary. Last kind of skills that haven't been developed during the program was basic digital literacy skills, such as using the university blackboard effectively and using PowerPoint and Word for educational purposes. As we can see in this slide, the data collected from the AAB related document was also agree with the data collected from the focus group interview with the Arabic teachers and with the semi-structured interviews with the student administrators. As it showed that the AA program was just focusing on developing student writing academic need. That was shown in these two tables. For example, in the first table in the left hand was show that the topic covered in the study skills syllables that taught to the fourth student in fourth level at the program was mainly focused on teach them how to use library, how to summarize and paraphrase reports, and how they can select the research theme and research plan, and how they can write resource and references and write brief research. All these topics indeed show how the program was just focusing in developing student academic writing skills. In the left, in the right hand, the table number 2, which is also related to study skills syllables, and show the target learning outcomes of the syllables. It also support the result, which is said that the syllables was also focusing on on developing the student academic writing skills and ignored the student and different academic learning and study need in different skills, such as listening, talking, reading, and academic learning academic. As we can see here, the data from the interviews with the student teachers and administrator found that the program failure to meet most of student academic needs relate to the different problematic factors that affect its effectiveness in satisfying these needs of a student. That including no attention given to the student actual need, the use of non-Arabic for academic purpose, specialized teacher, use of traditional teaching methods, use of inappropriate teaching material, lack of sufficient time and location for teaching AAP program. This result indeed supported by the data collected from the classroom observation, which found several relative results, including the textbook used in most of AAP classroom was the language textbook series used for teach student in general Arabic programs. Also, I found that in most AAP program, classrooms, teacher use a grammar-based approach and memorization technique to educate students in the language feature and skills. As I said before at the beginning of this presentation, relying on this study result, I developed a theoretical principle that can help teachers, course designers, decision makers to developing the AAP course design, whether in a practice or in course design process. Right here, a number of principles that need to be taken into account in order to develop the AAP course design. First one, they should understand that need analysis is a fundamental step in the process of AAP course design. They also need to understand the importance of investigate this need from different perspectives of all stakeholders, such as teacher, students, administrator, decision makers, and so on. Third things also that the contextual factors need also to be determined and considered before planning the designing the AAB course. Fourth principle is the AAB goals and objectives should be realistic, achievable, and clear. And reflect not just the institution objective, but also learner actual need and the teacher expectations of what their student will need at the territorial level. The fifth principle is teacher must be high qualified and fully aware of the principle and methodology of AAB teaching. Six is teaching should teaching method should shift from the traditional teacher-centered approach to the more student-centered approach. Seven, also the content of the AAB course should be adopted, designed on a research-based result of learner's need analysis instead of relying on the expectation or experience of teacher, administrators or decision makers. Eight, the AAB course syllables should be adopted from authentic text and material to accommodate the level of language and form of the text that a learner will expected to deal with in their target context. Six is the AAB content and syllables should also enhance learners' self-direction and autonomy needed for their target academic study. Principle that need be taken into consideration in developing AAP is the evaluation methods chosen, which is must be must be clear and measure the level of learners' performance in the skills acquired during the program. Now this slide will summarize the study methodology and main result. By using the case study methodology, the present study was aimed to explore the effectiveness of AAP program in meeting the academic need needs of overseas students at one university in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. At the end, depending on this study result, a theoretical principle for the development of the AAP programs practice in this particular context was developed. To achieve this study aim, a summative evaluation study was carried out using a triangulation method of data collection, including semi-structured interviews with overseas students and AAP administrators, focus group interview with AAP teacher, and direct observations of some AAP classrooms, as well as official AAP document was also collected to gain further information. The result of this study showed that the program focused on developing the student academic writing skill on account of their academic skills, their need of other academic skills, including listening skills, reading skills, speaking skills, and important academic vocabulary and basic digital literacy skills. Moreover, the result also found that the program was not success in meeting the student need because of a serious pedagogical problems that relate to its structures, content, and organization. These include no attention was given to the student actual need, the use of non-specialized Arabic for academic purpose teachers, the use of traditional teaching method, also the use of inappropriate teaching materials, and insufficient classroom duration and location. Thank you for your attention, and I hope you find what you're looking for from this presentation. Hi, Georgia.
Thank you very much. للأسف ما يبقى لنا وقت للأسئلة. هلا لازم نبدأ الاستراحة. ولكن لو سمحت إذا في أي سؤال راح نبعث لك إياها وممكن لو سمحت تجاوبي عليه عبر الشات. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for this presentation. And as I said, unfortunately, just because we're running out of time, we will send you any question and then you'll be answering via chat. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.